A very good morning to one and all. In oscilloscopes chapter, so we are discussing so different types of oscilloscopes: dual beam oscilloscope, dual trace oscilloscope, sampling oscilloscope, storage oscilloscope, and digital relay oscilloscope. And after the types of different oscilloscopes, we are going to measure the frequency of two signals. So for that, how we can measure the frequency of two signals by using the oscilloscope is discussed in today's session. So in today's session, we will discuss how to measure the unknown frequency signal with the known and standard frequency signal. So we can compare with the known signal frequency. With that, we can find the unknown signal frequency. So for that, measuring methods, there are three types of measuring methods are there. So with that, three types of measuring methods, we can find the frequency of the unknown signal. So there are three methods we can use for the measurement of frequency by using the CRO. So by using CRO, we can measure the unknown frequency. So for that, there are three methods are there. The first one is frequency measurement by Lissajous method. Frequency measurement by Lissajous method. And second one is spot wheel method. Spot wheel method, and third one is gear wheel method. So there are three methods. One is Lissajous method, spot wheel method, gear wheel method. Okay. So by using these three methods, we can measure the frequency of the unknown signal by using the CRO. So by using the CRO. Okay. So the first one. The frequency measurement by Lissajous method. So we will consider the first method. By using the Lissajous method, we are going to measure the frequency. So using this oscilloscope is a sensitive indicator for frequency and phase measurements. So by using this CRO, we can measure the frequency as well as the phase. And it is an indicator. It will be acts as an indicator. So for the applied signals, it will show some patterns, and from that pattern it will indicates the screen will be indicates the patterns. Okay, from that patterns we will find the frequency as well as the phase. So with this frequency method, Lissajous method, we can find the frequency as well as the phase difference of the two frequency signals. Phase difference between the two signals. So the frequency measurement by Lissajous method is simple and dependable, and measurement made at any frequency in the response range of the oscilloscope. So we can measure the frequency at any frequency range of the oscilloscope. Okay. And it is the easy method, and we can simple and dependable. Okay. So we can get the quick output with this method. So it is one of the quickest methods of determining frequency is by using Lissajous patterns. So for this on the screen. So the Lissajous patterns will produce on the screen. Okay. When the unknown signal is applied and the frequency of that signal is, we don't know, we have to find the unknown signal frequency. And another standard frequency signal and known frequency signal is applied. By applying these two signals to the deflecting plates of the CRO, so we will get different patterns on the CRT screen. On the CRT screen, we will get different patterns. They may be in the form of circle or ellipse. Okay, they may be in the form of circle, ellipse, or straight line. Okay, so like that we have different patterns, and these patterns are called as Lissajous patterns. And so here, so when the two sine wave signals are applied simultaneously, or both the plates are deflection plates, we will get some patterns. Okay, if one of the frequency is integral multiple of the other, the pattern will be stationary and is called as Lissajous figure. We can call it as the Lissajous figure or Lissajous patterns. Okay, the Lissajous figures will be obtained. Okay, when two frequency signals, suppose if you are applied sine wave signals simultaneously for both the deflection plates, for vertical deflection plates and horizontal deflection plates, we will apply the same sine wave signal. So at a time, how it will be obtained? So that will be represented as some pattern form. Okay. So similarly, if one frequency is an integral multiple of the other, if one frequency is integral multiple of the, that is harmonics of the other, then we will get a stationary. That means, so while adjusting the while adjusting the frequency, so the patterns will be changes. So when these patterns will be stationary, at that time we will consider. Okay, so we will see how it will be generate these patterns. So we have some procedure. And these Lissajous figures will be so here in the Lissajous method, we will apply a standard frequency to one set of deflection plates and unknown frequency to the maximum, it is maybe same amplitude, and simultaneously apply it to other set of the plates. So I was told, so for the both the deflection plates, we will apply the known frequency signal, standard frequency signal, and unknown frequency signals. So most of the cases for the unknown signal frequency is applied to the vertical plates, and standard and known frequency signal is applied for the horizontal deflection plates. The frequency of the signal, whose frequency of the signal is to be found, so that should be applied for the vertical deflection plates, and the known and standard frequency of the, I mean, it is same amplitude maybe, okay, so it is applied for the horizontal deflection plates. So and the pattern, the resulting pattern depends on the integral and the phase relationship between the two frequencies. Okay, so the obtained pattern will shows depending upon the frequency and the phase of the two frequencies. Generally, horizontal signal is designated as FH. The horizontal signal is represented by FH, and vertical signal is represented by FV. FH is signal for the horizontal deflection plates, and FV is signal which is applied for the vertical deflection plates. Okay, so here we have a measurement procedure. So how we can obtain these Lissajous patterns using the CRO. So first of all, we will set up the oscilloscope and switch off the intensity. So here, already I was explained, but synchronization, we have, there are three connections. So one is internal, line, and external. So these are connected to the sweep of the sweep generator on the horizontal deflection system. The horizontal deflection system, we have a trigger circuit, sweep generator, and a horizontal deflection amplifier. So here, before the trigger input is, the trigger input is should be connected to three points. So one is external, another one is internal, and the third one is a line connection. Okay, the internal connection is coming from the output of the vertical amplifier. The line connection is coming from the some external transformer. So the 230 volts is with frequency of 50 Hz is decreases to some 6.5 volts with the same frequency, and it is connected to the as a line frequency. And another another connection is there, that is the external connection. So the from the external connection, it will be connected to the trigger circuit. Okay, so for to get this resources patterns. Okay, so the internal sweep of the circuit is connected to the internal sweep is switch off, and that is connected to sweep. That is connected to the external point. Okay, and switch off this synchronization control. Connect the signal source as given in figure 7.3. So here this is the figure. So like this we will connect the signals. So this is the unknown frequency which is connected to vertical deflection plates, and this is the horizontal deflection plates, and the known frequency or the standard frequency signal is connected to the horizontal deflection plates. So in this system there is no connectivity from the vertical amplifier to horizontal deflection system. So we are separated. Oh, okay. So we are applying two separate signals to the director to the deflection plates. Okay, one is unknown frequency signal is applied to vertical deflection plates, and known and standard frequency signal is applying for the horizontal deflection plates. So like this, we can connect the both the signals, and on the CRT screen we will get some patterns. Okay, so those patterns also we will see. So once we will apply the unknown frequency, so next the intensity of the known frequency we have to adjust. So until the pattern will be standstill on the screen. Okay, the known frequency is adjusted to match the unknown frequency until when these two frequency signals are matched on the display, we will get some constant representation of these patterns. So they do not change. Okay, so the constant display will be present on the screen. So okay. So here the pattern stands still whenever FP and FH are in integral ratio. So either even or odd. Suppose if we have the frequency of the unknown signal is FP and the frequency of the known signal is also FH, and these two frequency signals are equal, so then we can get a single circle or an ellipse. So when both the frequency signals applied for the vertical and deflection plates are equal, so we will get a single circle, or we can call it as an ellipse also. So suppose when FP, the unknown frequency signal, is equal to 2FH, then we can get the two loop horizontal patterns, so which are shown in figure. Okay, so these are the Lissajous figures. These are just figures. So here in this case, in the figure A, so here we will get one single ellipse or a circle. Okay. So how to measure the unknown frequency is nothing but, so we will measure the how many horizontal loops and how many vertical loops are there, and the ratio of that is multiplied with the FH. FH is the known signal frequency. Okay, so here if we consider the A, so here on the horizontal side it is 1 and the vertical side it is 1. Okay, so here in this case the frequency FE is equals to FH. So both the frequencies, unknown and known frequencies, are equal. We will get a circular form of the representation. So coming to the B, So for the B, on the this pattern will be occurred when FV is equals to 2FH. FV is equals to 2FH. So how we can find it means? So we will find on the horizontal lines, how many horizontal loops. So if you draw a line here, if you draw a line by touching this particular loops, okay, so you will find that one loop, this is the one loop or one circle or one ellipse, and this is the second ellipse. Okay, so if you count on the horizontal, you will get 1 and 2. So in the vertical, we will get only this line is touching to only one loop. So that's why this will becomes as 2:1 ratio, and it is multiplied with the FH. So this becomes as the FV. So FV is the unknown frequency signal, and the unknown signal frequency is determined by the patterns, these are just figures. So by measuring a ratio horizontal loops to a ratio of horizontal loops to the vertical loops, and it is multiplied with the FH. So if we consider the figure C, so in this case we have 3 loops on the horizontal and 1 loop on the vertical. So this is only 1 loop. So horizontal it is 3, but vertically it is single. So that's why it becomes as a 3:1, or FV is equals to 3FH. And if we consider, this is a D figure, FV is equals to, in the horizontal we have 4 loops which are touching to a line, 1, 2, 3, 4, and on the vertical it is 1. And for figure, this is the 4F, FV is equals to 4FH. And for the figure E, so there are 5 loops on the horizontal and vertical it is 1, and it becomes as the FV is equals to 5FH. And coming to figure F, so on the horizontal it is 1, horizontal it is touching 1, and in the vertically it is touching 2 loops, so it is 1:2, and it is multiplied with the horizontal frequency signal. Okay, and it will produce as the FV, so unknown signal frequency. And coming to figure G, this figure G, for this horizontal it is 1, and vertically it is touching 3 loops, 1, 2, 3, so 1:3 into FH. Okay, and for figure H, it is horizontal it is 1 and vertical it is 4, so it becomes as 1:4 FH. And for the figure I, you can draw this side also, no problem. So on the horizontal it is 1 and vertical it is 5, and it is multiplied with the FH. So with this you can get the unknown signal frequency. So by using the Lesage's patterns. Okay. So either of the cases, it is just 1:4, 1:5. Okay. Or it will be integer values. So we can also have some. Ratios also there. By using not an integer values, we can also have some ratios will also produce. So those figures also we'll see. From the list of these figures, we will determine the frequency by counting the number of horizontal loops in the pattern to divide by the number of vertical loops, and it will multiply with the known or standard frequency. So this is all explained that only. So the next one, so after this we are used for measurement of the frequency. Okay, so the same list of this figures are used for the measurement of the phase also. Suppose we have two equal frequencies, and same phase, then we will get a straight line which is a 45 degrees angle with the horizontal. So here we have, when two signals are equal and have the same phase, then we don't get any Lissajous pattern. So we will get some a straight line with 45 degrees. Okay, so we will get some a straight line with the 45 degrees of the angle with the horizontal. Okay, so like this, with respect to phase and the frequency, both are equal. So we will get a straight line and having some the straight line this with the 45 degrees angle, this line will be there. Similarly, so as the phase between two alternative signals changes, if the phase is same, we will get a straight line. If the phase is different, but equal frequency, same frequency, and having the phase is different, so in such situation, we will get different patterns. So that is, we will get an ellipse when the phase difference is pi by 4. That is 45 degrees. When the two signals, two alternating signals are having a phase difference of pi by 4, so then we will get an ellipse. So when the phase difference is pi by 4 between two frequency signals, we will get an ellipse. Okay, and when the phase difference is pi by 2, so when the phase difference is 90 degrees between the two input signals, and we will get a circle. Similarly, the phase difference is 3 pi by 4. So that is 135 degrees. So in such situation, we will get an ellipse, and we will get a straight line pattern when the phase difference is pi by radians. So first of all, so when the phase difference between two signals is zero, and the phase difference between two signals is zero, we will get a straight line. If suppose phase difference is 45 degrees between two signals, we will get some ellipse. If the phase difference is 90, then we will get a circle. So this is like a circle. And if it is 135 phase difference between two signals, we will get again an ellipse. And the phase difference between is 180 degrees, that is pi radians, so then we will get again a straight line. So like this, both the signals or frequencies are having same frequency and having some phase difference. Okay, so based upon these obtained representations, we can measure the phase difference between the two signals. Okay, so it will follow the straight line, ellipse, circle, ellipse, and straight line. Suppose the phase is changing from pi to 2 pi. The phase is changing between 2 pi and 2 pi. So then the first, it will follow the, it will produce the straight line, next ellipse, circle, ellipse, straight line. So same sequence will be repeated. Okay, ellipse, cycle, ellipse, and straight line. So this particular sequence will be repeated from the pi 2 to pi. The phase difference between two frequency signals is having phase difference of pi to 2 pi. In such situation, it will again follow a straight line, so ellipse pattern, circle, ellipse, and straight line pattern. So from these patterns, we can find the phase difference between two signal frequencies, two frequency signals. Okay. So what we had explained previously, that is given here also, same. So the phase difference between two signals, changes from pi to 2 pi radians. The pattern changes correspondingly through the ellipse, circle, ellipse, cycle, to a straight line. Okay. So hence the two frequencies as well as the phase displacement can be compared using Lissajous figures technique. So by using this technique, we can compare the two frequencies as well as the phase phase difference by using the Lissajous figures. When the two frequencies being compared are not equal, but have fractionally related and more complex stationary pattern results, which is dependent on the frequency ratio and relative phase between the two signals. So previously, we have seen those Lissajous patterns. When the two frequency signals, applied frequency signals are equal. So if the applied two signals are not equal, so we'll get some complicated patterns will come. Stationary patterns will come. And those are depend upon the difference between the frequency and the phase difference, relative phase difference of the two signals. So the below figure shows the patterns for the non-integral frequencies. So in this case, we will see how we can measure. So these are different patterns that are produced. So when the two frequency signals are not equal, okay, and having certain phase difference. Okay. So if we same, the procedure is same. So measuring is same. So how we can find out means? So for this, we have also draw a horizontal line on the horizontal line. And for this, how many loops are touching? So that we will be count. So in the horizontal line, it is 1, 2, 3. 3, 5. On the vertical, we have 1 and 2. So two loops are touching. So that is 3/2 into FH. So this is the FV. So unknown signal frequency, FV is equals to 3/2 into FH. Okay. And for coming to this figure, so on the horizontal it is touching two loops, 1 and 2. And the vertically it is touching 1, 2, 3. Okay. So it becomes as 2/3 FH. So coming to this figure, so on the horizontally it is touching the 4 loops, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 loops. So 5. On the vertical it is touching 1 and 2. So 2 loops. So it is 5/2. So non-integral ratio. So that is 5/2 into FH. That is equals to FV. Okay. And coming to this picture, so on the horizontally it is touching 2 loops. Okay. And the vertically it is touching 5 loops. So 1 and 2. So 2/5. 2/5 into FH. The FH is the non-frequency signal. Okay. And that produces the unknown signal frequency FV. So like this, we can produce the, we will obtain the Lissajous patterns for not the two frequency signals are not unequal. Okay, and for that we will find this unknown signal frequency. When the two signals are not same, are not equal. Okay, so we will produce some complicated patterns like this. First is a circle type of patterns we will observe. Whereas in this case, it is produces a non-integral frequencies. Non-integral frequencies. So how we can measure? This is the formula. Based upon this formula, we can find out the unknown signal frequency. So the fractional relationship between the two frequencies is determined by counting the number of cycles in the vertical and the horizontal. So we have to count the number of cycles or loops. We can call this loops or cycles also. Okay, number of cycles in the vertical and horizontal. So FV is equals to fraction into FH. So the fraction is equal to the number of horizontal tangencies to the number of vertical tangencies. So when we draw a line to the vertical and horizontally, so the loops which are touching the tangential line, so our straight line. So how many loops or cycles are touching that straight line will give the number of horizontal tangencies. And for the vertical, the how many loops or cycles which are touching this particular vertical line will produce the number of vertical tangencies. So based upon this FV and FH, so we'll get this ratio and this fraction, and FV is equals to fraction into FH. Okay. So like this, we will find out the unknown signal frequency using Lissajous method by using Lissajous figures. And the second one is a spot wheel method for frequency measurement. So it is another method for measurement of the frequency measurement. So spot wheel method. So in this case, when this method is used, it means, so by using the Lissajous patterns, and so if the frequency between two signals is very high, or the ratio is very high, okay, if the ratio is increasing value, so in such situation, we will get a very complicated patterns. The ratio between the two signal frequencies is increasing the order. So in such situation, the obtained patterns are having complicated, very complicated patterns will be displayed on the CRT screen. So from that, it is difficult to identify the tangencies. Okay, so in such situation, we have to go for the spot wheel method. Okay, in such cases, it is advantageous to use the spot wheel method. Okay, and an intensity modulated circular or elliptical is produced on the face of the CRT. Okay, so here we will use the spot wheel method for the display of the frequency measurement. When it is difficult to interpret using the Lissajous method. So this is the basic circuit for a spot wheel method for the frequency measurement. So here we have vertical deflection plates and horizontal deflection plates, vertical and horizontal. So here the signal which is applied, so here you don't have any we don't apply the standard frequency signal. So we will apply this signal. That is the supposition, this is the low frequency signal. So that low frequency signal is applied to the phase shifter. This is the phase shifter. So RC phase shift, okay, it will provide a phase shift of 90 degrees. We can adjust the phase shift value. Okay, suppose it is producing 90 degrees phase shift. So from here, it will apply to the horizontal deflection plates. See here. So with this, we will apply the for the vertical deflection plates, and from this it is applied for the horizontal deflection plates. The same signal which is applied to measure the unknown frequency. So that signal is separated by two signals by providing a phase shift. So in this spot we'll measure. Okay. So with that we will get some dots like circle. So a circle will be formed by having some dots. Okay. So with this we can get the some ratio. Okay. So f high to f low is equals 20. So frequency of high is equals to 20 into f low. So this we'll discuss in detail in the next class. So how this circle life of the structure, dots like circle, will be obtained in detail we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, so if you have any doubts or clarification about this this pattern, you can ask the question through chat. In the chat box you can type if you have any doubts or clarification. If you have any doubts, if you don't have any doubts, I am closing this session. So we'll see the spot wheel method and the tomorrow spot wheel method and the gear wheel methods. These two will be discussed in tomorrow's session. Okay, thank you one and all.